Welcome to the Scariest Cut Podcast,
where we dissect the most horrific moments in cinema.
Today we're talking about 2023's Evil Dead Rise.
I don't know if you've noticed, but we've been away from the podcast for...
Yeah, it's been a
few months.
A while.
We'll say a few months. We've been working on some other stuff. We are going to revise our podcast, our format.
Yes, we are not going to run through the entire movie anymore. Just the scariest cuts, because that makes the most sense.
Yeah, it's kind of aligned with what we're already doing.
Yeah, probably should have figured that out before.
So there are a lot of great podcasts out there that will run through pretty much the entire movie, scene by scene. Yeah. We're not going to do that. We want to talk about just the good stuff.
Yeah, so if you haven't seen the movie we're talking about, you should go watch it.
You but should.
If you just want to know some of the stuff in it, keep listening.
Yep, so Evil Dead Rise. Evil Dead, obviously, is a bigger franchise.
Yeah, it's one of the few without any missteps to me.
Yeah.
Yeah, all good movies, even the show. I love the show.
And you know, and a lot of the movies are all different, too.
Yeah. Well, it's like everyone has a different vibe to it.
Yeah.
The first one was clearly they were trying to make something, and
they did a good job. Yeah.
It was just very low budget.
Yeah.
And then second one, he made what he wanted. Much goofier.
Much goofier. Bruce Campbell nailed it.
Yep.
Third one,
Army of Darkness.
Goofy, it's completely
very
different
weird.
Setting.
2013,
yeah. The remake. One of the best remakes, in my opinion.
Yeah, I love that movie.
Yep.
It's like so dark and gory, but feels Evil Dead.
Yep. And this one is also dark.
Yeah.
Evil Dead Rise. Darker. This takes place in like a urban setting, so a high rise.
Yes. Rise.
Rise. Evil,
Evil Dead.
Dead
Rise.
Rise. So here we go. We're going to jump into some of the scariest moments of the film.
Yeah, which on this movie kicks it off right away.
Great opening to this film. This first scariest thing, I guess, is we're in this cabin with two girls, and one of them is sick.
Yes. Clearly, she is possessed.
Yep. So she has turned into a deadite. One of the, the most gruesome...
This was probably the
moments.
Goriest as far as like seeing something happen.
There's a lot of gore in this
film.
There's
a lot of blood and stuff, but this was the one that will make you like cringe.
Yeah, this was like cringy. So
she gets scalped.
Yeah, so the deadite grabs this other girl, I think it's her cousin, grabs her by her hair, like wraps the hair around her hand, and then just yanks on it. Rips her scalp, like right off. It's gross.
Yep. Doesn't even kill her.
Very cool scene. Yeah. This is happening, first few minutes of this movie.
This is like the first 3 minutes. We're already here.
I'm like, all right, here we go.
Now this girl comes stumbling out on a dock.
Yeah.
Just bleeding out her head.
Yep, so the deadite comes out, and her boyfriend is there. And there's this drone that the boyfriend was flying throughout the opening.
And her deadite, is it Jessica?
Yes.
Did I get that name right? Okay, yes.
Jessica, yep.
She grabs that drone and slams it into her face.
Yep. Just slams it into her, and it knocks her into the water. The boyfriend has to...
He's a hero. He jumps in.
Jumps in to save her, but what happens?
He gets his head ripped off.
The head flies out.
Yeah. Which there is like the slight comedy of Evil Dead. Like,
yes.
It's gory, but it has fun with it.
Yeah, this was fun. So the head just lands on this deck.
Yeah. Just facing the camera, and then she comes floating out of the water... And we get a great title card.
Yeah.
And just Evil Dead Rise. This
cool tone, music,
yeah,
whatever hits you.
Really good opening.
Yeah, very chilling.
Right away, you're like, I'm in for some fun.
Yeah.
Yep. And then the movie keeps going.
Keeps going. So I guess the next scariest moment to talk about in this film, just some quick background. It's really about this family. So it's a mother, her three kids, and then...
The aunt, Auntie Beth.
Yep, Auntie Beth. So... what happens here, the mother is the one that gets turned. So Necronomicon shows up, blah, blah, blah.
They find in the basement, and now she gets possessed in an elevator.
Yeah, so this demon like rushes into her, knocks her back. This really cool scene of, it's an homage to the first one.
Yes, the tree molestation,
yes,
I'll call it.
Good way to put it. So the wires like wrap around her limbs and like start choking her out. And at one point, it pulls so hard, it, like, breaks her. Her arm just turns and breaks, and it's cool. It's just, very graphic.
Evil Dead's always been real good with body horror.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, very much. Which we'll get to at the end, because it's very Cronenberg-like scene. So that happens. So that was a very cool scene. So now she's turned. She's our main villain. Then, what happens next?
She comes back to the apartment, and she's not doing well, so...
Yeah, so they think she's dead, right?
Yeah.
And then I guess she comes back to life?
Yeah, they put her in the tub?
Yeah.
She's not... You saw this twice.
I mean, she's a deadite, right? So she comes back, and they're like, oh, she's burning up. So they throw her in this tub. You've probably seen this if you've watched the preview.
Yeah, this was heavily focused on in all the trailers and the promos.
Yeah, where she like jumps up and she's like hanging on the wall.
Yeah, and great line, and it's pretty much the line that you'll see on any of the promos. It's the mommies with the maggots now.
Yeah.
That's great. And then, yeah, she's on the ceiling taunting them.
It was creepy, and then she ends up falling into the tub again, and then she slides out of the tub. Almost like... you know, what's that Japanese movie?
I was going to say, it's very kind of that Grudge? Japanese style. The Grudge or... Oh, The Ring.
The Ring. Yeah.
It is very much that, like, the creepy crawlies.
Yeah, which there's a line that they actually mention.
Oh, yeah, the creepy the crawlies. Daughter later.
Yeah. A lot of nods to other horror movies throughout this. A lot of them, which was great. She ends up, when she's out of the tub, she grabs a piece of the mirror. And she ends up attacking Auntie Beth. And stabs her through the hand with this piece of mirror.
These people in these movies get just the shit beat out of them the entire time.
Oh, and that thing was just in her hand. She's like holding it back. I think one of the son.
Yeah.
Is that one? Hits her with a chair or something?
Yeah, he knocks her over.
Oh, wait, the tattoo gun. So that's
what I have. Yeah, this was one scene where... The anticipation of what's about to happen is... Because she's trying to tattoo her eye, right?
Yeah, so the mother was a tattoo artist, which we find out in the beginning. So there's a tattoo gun, and she gets on the daughter, and she's got this gun, you know, with a little needle, and it's, like, super close to her eye. So if you don't, like, eyeball, you know,
it's
horror.
That's one of those things that no one likes it. So it just, and it's that build-up and the close-up shots and stuff.
Yeah, good tension here.
But she does not succeed.
She doesn't hit her eye, but she does scrape her face. Which comes into play.
Yeah, that's enough for a deadite.
Right. So that will come into play in a little bit. Anyway, yeah, she gets knocked over by the son. Ends up being, like, thrown outside.
Yeah, and they get her on the hallway, because these scenes I love through the peephole.
Yes.
It's kind of this fisheye lens. You can only see a little bit of the hallway.
Yeah.
And her face just keeps coming into it and talking. It's creepy. Yeah.
But, so the next... scariest moment we'll talk about is when Gabe is his name, the bigger, you know, the strong guy, whatever. The mother ends up biting into his eyeball, which is awesome, rips out his eye, turns and spits it into, like, there's a kid that's in the hallway, spits, and this is the comedy.
Yeah.
That's very Evil Dead, spits it right into the kid's mouth. The kid ends up swallowing it. It's disgusting.
Yeah, they always have fun with the gore is the comedy in these movies.
Like, yeah.
Besides for maybe 2013, but...
Yeah, this guy isn't dead yet, which you think he's dead after this, but he's not. But that was a very cool... That was maybe the funniest?
That's probably the peak of the humor in this movie.
Yeah, the comedy is very subtle in this Evil Dead film.
Yeah, it's the very much the gore in a comedic way.
Yep. So now the mother is locked out of the apartment complex, and she's banging her head on the door. We've seen that done before.
Yeah. It's hereditary. Did it.
This had some hereditary
moments. It's got that family vibe and stuff.
Yeah. Yep. And that's when we, you know, the peephole, which he was just talking about, pretty cool looking. A kid gets thrown into a wall.
That did make me laugh.
Yeah.
It's just, you see it through this peephole, and just, and it looks like his arms were ripped off or something, and also the body just slams up against the wall.
Mm-hmm. So that's, like, we'll call that a kill. And then Gabe, who just got his eyeball ripped out, he comes back up. So he's, like, screaming into the door. You see him, like, looking through the peephole, and then he gets his throat slashed, which is...
Yeah, she just fucks up everyone else in this place.
Yeah, yeah, a lot of people die.
Yeah.
A lot of people die. So Gabe is officially dead.
Yes, she got him this time.
Or turned.
Ooh.
Oh, I don't know.
Stay tuned.
Yep. And there's another guy, an old guy who smokes a cigarette, and he's got a shotgun. He dies off camera.
Don't get to see that one.
Yeah.
But, well, she shoots him or something? Or
I don't know.
You don't really know what happens.
Dead. He dies off camera. So next scariest scene, I guess, would be Bridget, who is not the youngest daughter, but like...
Yeah, I believe she's the middle child.
Yep. Yeah, because the son drives.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. So that little slash, I guess did it.
Yeah, she's infected.
She's infected, so...
to get the black veins running through.
Yeah, pretty cool scene here where the blood starts, like, pouring from her eyes and her nose.
Yeah.
And then she ends up, like, puking up maggots. It's really gross.
Creepy crawlies.
So she's turning at this point. What do I got here? Oh, they almost let the mom in. There's a scene where, like,
youngest daughter is very young.
Yeah.
She's, like, 6 or 7 or something.
Seven,
so
we'll say.
She's constantly at the peephole because it's her mom.
Yep.
So that's also creepy.
Her mom tries to coax her to let her in. Almost does. So she's got the, you know, mom has the little girl. But yeah. They end up, like, whatever, getting rid of her. But then they go back. Yeah, they show her. Right. So then they go back in the kitchen and they see that Bridget has turned. Right. So after she, you know, puked up, blah blah blah, she's a deadite now. She's like on the counter, all propped up,
crouched over, and she's
as she turns, she's like chewing glass.
She's eating a wine glass.
Yeah. So we hear this crunching, and you see the bits of glass
as she swallows it. Just the close up on like the poking through the neck.
Yeah, very cool. Very cool scene here. So you see that glass poking through. And then she ends up attacking
Auntie Beth.
What am I going to say?
Her name's Beth.
Beth. We'll go Beth. I'm just going to say Beth. All right. She attacks Beth. So I don't know if you've seen the poster. But there's a cheese grater.
Yeah, they were starting to use because it was in a trailer, and then I think the idea grossed everyone out.
Yeah,
so it became like a poster, and I think Fright Rags did a T-shirt that was like cheese grater. The scene was because of that.
It was a letdown.
It was slightly disappointing.
It was kind of a letdown because I wanted to see something horrific happen.
Yeah, I was like, oh, that's gonna be like a scene, and it's such a throwaway because she just kind of scrapes it on her leg, which still, if you ever cut yourself with a cheese grater, it sucks.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure it's gonna hurt. But he really scrapes the skin.
But it's
off.
Like, yeah, the thigh or something. I'm like, that was it.
That was it. So wanted a little bit more there. If you're going to advertise this kind of stuff, right?
Yeah, that was.
You better have some cool payoff.
Yeah. Like I get, like they don't control the commercials and that stuff, but it was the wrong thing to maybe promote.
It was.
I mean, I'm kind of glad because everything else that happened was so much more impactful.
They could have promoted an elevator.
Yeah, the elevator does play a big role.
Yeah, in the beginning and at the end.
Later on.
So, but we'll get to the end. So anyway, cheese grater into Beth's leg. She ends up hitting her with a spatula, which doesn't do much because she just like ends up turning and like laughing. So then Beth grabs like a pot, really a heavy one, nails her in the head. So I guess the pot doesn't knock her out because she goes after the little one. Cassie is her name. And then so Cassie has this like wooden stake basically that Bridget runs into. Face first, and it goes right through like the back of her skull and stuns her. And then she ends up passing out.
Yeah.
That's when they tie her up.
Yeah.
Cause that makes sense. Yeah.
These things don't die.
Yeah, they don't die. They just, I don't know. You slow them down, I guess.
Pretty much.
Yeah. So that was a cool scene. Bridget flies. So I have So she ends up, she's tied up and she has a sheet over her. Right, but now the mother is crawling through the grates.
Yeah, that scene creeped me out.
Yeah, and Bridget gets up, so it's almost ghost-like. It's pretty cool. It's pretty because you see her just like walking in the background, which is creepy. And then at one point, she ends up like flying at Danny. And there's like a stab scene. So she takes a knife and she stabs Danny, who is the
oldest brother.
The oldest brother. And then he basically dies, so whatever.
Yeah, that was but anticlimactic.
But right before he dies, another very cool scene. He takes a lighter, some kind of spray bottle. Do you remember this? And the fire and lights Bridget on fire.
I do remember him lighting. I don't remember what he used, but
I forget what he used. I don't know what it is, but I think he uses the stove. Does he use the stove to like use this spray to spray at her and it just burns her up? So that was cool. That was a cool looking scene. So now she's like just gross and disgusting. She's a gross, disgusting deadite.
As they all are.
Yeah, but she's even more. let's see. As she's on top of Danny, like basically killing him, she's puking blood on top of
his
face.
Yeah, making these movies has to be fun.
Oh, there's some gross stuff, man. There's some puking and some bile. And
everyone is just covered in fake blood by the end of this.
Oh, yeah. By the end of this, they're just completely red. Yep. Yeah. There is this scene where Beth is listening to a record, and the mother ends up showing up behind her.
Yeah, this was kind of another Hereditary-like scene, and it worked.
It did.
You just see, like, the focus is on Beth, but in the background you could see her, like, crawling on the ceiling.
Yeah, so she ends up behind her. She's listening to a record. I didn't even put this in my notes, but something very creepy that she does, the mother ends up putting her fingernail on this record that's playing, and she opens her mouth, right? And it's, like, frightening. And it's coming out of her mouth.
That was a cool scene.
Very cool. Very chilling. And then she attacks Beth. Yeah, that was a very cool scene.
They're able to do a lot with the... Because they're so, like... Everything is in, like, one setting in these movies.
Yeah.
And they get to do so much.
They do, yeah. Very creative.
Like, the old one was Cabin. Mm-hmm. I'm like, that's it.
Yep. So that was cool. When she attacks Beth, Beth ends up taking a pair of scissors and jams it up like the nose of the mother.
It's like open too.
It's like right through her. And that stuns her for a bit. So now she's like the dead-eyed's dead, sleeping, whatever you want to say.
It's like a video game.
Yeah.
You hit him. She's stunned for a bit.
So she's stunned for a bit. So that was cool. And then she tries to, you know, the... Beth and the youngest daughter, Cassie, those are the only two that are alive at this point. So they go outside to leave. They're trying to get out of here.
Yeah, they've been trapped in this building.
They've been trapped, and some cool stuff happens in this hallway.
This was the scene that I was like, what? Because stuff starts getting crazy here.
Stuff does start getting crazy. So at one point, Beth grabs the shotgun from that old guy.
Need a boomstick.
Oh, that's true. Yeah. I didn't even think of that.
Chainsaw comes in later.
I know the chainsaw, but I didn't even think of the boomstick. Because wasn't that a sawed-off shotgun?
I think it did.
Yeah. Close enough. One. Close enough. And she ends up using the shotgun to shoot off the leg of the mother, which is kind of funny. kind of cool.
Gotta slow him down.
There was a scary scene there where the mother's like flying at her.
Yeah.
If you remember that. But yeah, her leg gets blown off, and then her arm gets blown off. And then the two kids come into play. This gets really cool.
Yeah, this was a really good scene.
Yeah, so some more stuff happens, but basically the kids are digging into their mother.
Going back to the womb.
Oh, it's gross. They're using their hands and they're like digging in, and they're basically joining each other?
Yeah, it's kind of a, like you said, Cronenberg.
Yeah. It
reminds me of The Thing a lot. They're becoming one.
There's a scene where when you're looking at the Necronomicon, there is a page where it shows.
Yeah. Like we looked at it. They're calling what it becomes the Marauder.
Okay.
So I don't know if that was in the movie at all. But.
Yeah. So really, this was another gory, gross...
Yeah, this is everything just gets, like...
Scary scene.
Gooey and bloody at this point.
Yeah, and you're like, oh my god, this is this guy. And they just... Oh, the kid Danny's all bloody and nasty, and then you got the burnt... You know? Like, it just looked... It looks sick, man.
Is this also with all of the other people in the hallway?
Yeah. Yeah, and now all of a sudden they start chanting.
Yeah. Dead by Dawn.
Dead by Dawn.
Which is the subtitle for the second movie.
Little callback,
yep,
which was nice.
So they're chanting this as they run off to get in the elevator, which is broken.
So they're in this elevator. This is, you know, we mentioned the elevator being a thing here. The elevator basically starts filling with blood from the bottom all the way up. I heard that they use like thousands and thousands of gallons of blood.
I think they're trying to top 2013's
like
rain.
Like the remake? Yeah. So they used a lot of blood.
Yeah, they're going full Shining.
Yeah, so basically, you see this sign on the elevator, like max capacity, 900 pounds, whatever. It fills up with blood. It ends up falling. And yes, you get that homage to...
Yeah, it crashes, those doors open, and all that blood comes out.
Yeah. And they wake up, whatever. But that was a very gory scene, obviously.
Yeah.
Maybe the goriest? I mean, it's the most blood used.
It's the most blood, that's for sure.
Yep. Now, they're in the garage, they're trying to get out, and this monster...
Yeah, this is probably when we get to really see it.
This three-headed...
like, spider creature.
Very Cronenberg.
Yeah, it's like the mother's body, and then the two kids are, like, coming out of her.
It was cool, but it, you know, it didn't, like, it didn't frighten me.
It didn't. Like, I've seen stuff like this, and also it...
Sure.
Like, I've never seen stuff like this in Evil Dead.
So no.
That did feel a bit odd.
Yeah, this...
Like, I know they kind of don't have rules. They just do whatever for the movies.
Is this like kind of like Resident Evil? I don't know. It just feels...
It was odd.
Yeah. It wasn't like completely out of place. It just...
No, it worked in the movie, but it wasn't what I was expecting to happen.
Right.
Not this, like, Cronenberg monster at the end.
Yeah.
Which they now have to rid...
Yeah, whatever. And the thing's not—it's not super menacing or anything. It's just like this bunch of limbs.
It's a creepy CGI-esque. It might be practical.
I think some of it was practical.
It's probably a lot of practical.
Yeah.
Nowadays, I'm like, it could be CGI or practical. Both of the companies have gotten so good at what they do.
Yeah. But Cassie, the little girl, gets grabbed by the monster, and then Beth, she's trying to. She gets locked out, and then she busts her way back in, and the monster's about to... Well, monster finds a chainsaw.
Yeah.
Right? So...
Need a chainsaw.
So Beth shoots the monster with a shotgun. The monster drops the chainsaw. The little girl goes running.
Yeah, there's a lot of lawn equipment in this parking garage.
Oh, yeah. In this parking garage, there's a wood chipper.
Yeah.
So... This is going to come into
convenient.
Play. Conveniently, yep. The thing's running now, right? The monster turns it on, blah, blah, blah. So, So now the chainsaw's in play. So Beth grabs the chainsaw. It's very Evil Dead, right?
Gotta start cutting it up.
Yep. So shove this. This looked pretty cool. This was some good gore.
Yeah, this was good.
Just jams the chainsaw right into the thing to push it back into the wood chipper. And she's like cutting the three of them up, which is awesome.
Yeah.
And then one of the last scenes is she takes the chainsaw and jams it straight down into the head of the mother. It looked really cool. Whatever. Everything pretty much goes into the wood chipper except for the mother's head.
Of course,
right? So the mother head says something to her, and Beth...
That's always a fun part of Evil Dead. Like, you can cut them all up. Still, the head will be talking.
Yeah, it was just
the
head.
These demons are chatty.
Mm-hmm. So Beth kicks the head.
Yep, got to have that hair line.
Yeah, soccer style, right into the wood chipper.
It's pretty much the movie. The opening scene did take place... the following day, so we kind of follow up with that.
We do follow up with that. So we get a scene, the next day?
Yeah, the girl from the opening finds the book.
The girl, yeah. So she's leaving to go to this cabin. She's on the phone with the girl who she killed.
Yeah, she was in this apartment, right, the entire time. And
there's some questions there.
Had a peaceful night.
There's some questions
I'm guessing she was on a different floor.
Definitely a different floor. Probably the bottom, we'll say. So the demon ends up flying into her now. We get a scream.
Yep.
And then we get another title card. So Evil Dead Rise.
So it was a lot of fun.
It was.
I had a lot of fun with this one. It's got a lot. I mean, this is one that it's kind of nonstop, creepy or bloody. So
once it gets going, it does get going.
Yeah. There's like, there's a lot of middle part where you're just getting to know the characters.
A little setup. Yeah.
Which I like all the characters.
Strong opening setup. And then once that mother turns, you know, a lot starts happening.
Yeah, she's menacing and creepy.
Mm-hmm.
Like, the facial expressions and the makeup on her.
She was great.
She's really good.
The whole cast, I think, did a bang-up job. Great acting.
Yeah, and these were, like, all relatable characters in a way. Like, these aren't normal movie characters.
Cool, like, progressive characters. Yeah. Like, the teenagers and stuff. Yeah, just had some personality to them.
They're not, like, they're all kind of struggling in life. And, like, she's a tattoo artist with three kids.
And she has to move out of this complex. Like, everybody's like, moving out of that high-rise.
Very well-done movie. And thank God. Need good Evil Dead.
It was Evil Dead. It's not a bad... Yeah, you will probably enjoy it.
Yeah.
How much you enjoy it... I'll be honest with you, when I saw it the first time, and we watch movies all the time, and we talk about movies, and we rate movies, right? So, like, I'm going into it with, like, that critic mindset, and I'm like, this has to top the last one in my head. So, I watched it. I was like, it's not as good as the last one.
Yeah.
It wasn't. It was. I still love the last one more.
2013 was just so strong for me.
Right. It had something to it, right? This one, I did watch it a second time. I went by myself. I was like, I got to see this movie again because I knew we were going to talk about it on the podcast. And I did like it more the second time. And you had mentioned, like, maybe you just didn't have those, like, high expectations going into it. You kind of knew.
I find that a lot now with these movies. If I do give them a second watch, I'm always like, it wasn't as bad as I thought.
Sure.
Or, like, I just like it or have a lot more fun with it.
Yeah. Yeah, and I think that was definitely the case for me.
Yeah, it's kind of also, like, the anticipation of if you're, like, looking forward to a movie.
Yeah.
It's hard to live up to the...
Like, you want it to be a 10, right? And if it's not a 10, it's like,
And
God.
Now it's like, there's so much. Like, we're watching movies every day.
I know.
So it's hard, but...
But this movie was great. It didn't, like, add too much to the franchise. It was a great movie. It did add the three Necronomicons.
Yeah, which I'm wondering. Definitely, this movie did very well. So.
It did. Yeah. I think it doubled their budget within the first weekend.
So I... think we're gonna see a sequel, probably.
I hope so.
Like, I would like to see them stick to a story, because now they keep... I like the, like, side stories, and they do kind of make it seem like this is maybe all in the same universe, which is a bit weird, because Ash's Evil Dead stuff is crazy now.
I know.
And I think he's officially retired the character.
I think he has. Which, would love to see him come back.
It would be nice for even a cameo.
You know, like the whole Batman thing. Yeah. What's his name? Is coming
Michael
back.
Keaton's coming back.
Yeah, he's coming back, so maybe
he's also coming back as Beetlejuice.
Oh, that's going to be great.
Stay tuned.
We'll cover that another day.
Yeah, probably in 2 years.
So, Evil Dead Rise. We're not going to tell you what our scariest cut is. We will probably do a bonus episode. When I say episode, it's our scariest cut episodes, which, by the way, you can follow us on.
TikTok.
Yep.
Instagram. Mm-hmm. YouTube.
Facebook
all right now.
Facebook is doing all right. Slasher, Twitter.
We're on all of them.
Yeah. It really does actually help us out. Yes. No pressure, but... Yeah, that's it. That's Evil Dead Rise.
Yeah, so we're going to be back with more podcasts.
Yeah, we're going to do this a little bit.
Don't know what we're doing next, so we'll have to plan that, but we'll figure it out.
We will figure it out. Thank you very much, everybody, for listening or watching us.
Appreciate it.
Any final words?
Good night.